Hello everybody, welcome back to Nakshatra Nuggets from Saptarishis Astrology. Today we take you to a series of Nakshatra Nuggets in a different twist, So far, Nakshatras and their qualities are used on a very, very mundane and a very, very small level. Let us explore what these Nakshatra qualities can impart in our own birth charts. The Nakshatras have a lot many quality. Some are Dhruva or Sthira. Some Nakshatras are Dhruva or Sthira. This means they are fixed or permanent. Like Rohini, Uttara Falgani, Uttara Ashada, Uttara Bhadrapada. That is, all the Uttaras and Rohini are fixed set of Nakshatras. Chara or movable or ephemeral. These Nakshatras show movement, be it Punarvasu, Swati, Shravana, Dhanishta and Satabhisha. Next, we see Tikshna or sharp or dreadful Nakshatras. These Nakshatras are Nakshatras which show very strong sharp cutting quality edges. Adra, Ashlesha, Jeshta and Mula. Of the two, Ashlesha and Jeshta are the Nakshatra of Mercury and Adra is Rahu's Nakshatra and Mula is your Ketu's Nakshatra. Mridu or soft, the soft, mild, tender. Mrigasira, Chitra, Anuradha, Revati. Misra, the one that shows contrasting yet beautiful qualities, the sharp and the soft. It takes color from the planet positioned there. Kritika and Vishakha. Ugra, fierce or severe. Bharani, Magha, Purva Phalguni, Purva Ashada and Purva Bhadrapada. Finally, we come to Laghu and Kshipra. The one that is light, that is small, fast and swift. These nakshatra consist of Ashwini, Pushya, Hasta and Abhijita. Abhijita, as you all know, is the 20th nakshatra, which was pushed out of orbit by Lord Krishna. Yet, a part of it does affect the human beings, the 12 zodiacs, and part of it lies in Uttara Bhadrapada and Shravana. Moving ahead, we see that what does Dhruva state, what does it help us to do? It is a time to do something which is long lasting. It is a time when we do things that will help us, that we want to last longer, like marriages, long-term investments, laying foundations of house, doing Griha Pravesh or housewarming ceremonies, oath taking, commencement of a good job, Chara Nakshatra. Things that we want to move in our life, like vehicles, machineries, animals. Events done in this nakshatra are repeated. Tikshna Nakshatra. This is done for plotting against enemies, getting your work done at any cost. Related work done for ablution of our ancestors, and they're good for doing illegal antisocial deeds like cheating, tantra and black magic, which includes hurting people or killing them. Mridu Nakshatra, they're used for new relationships and starting of new relationships. They're suitable for various auspicious ceremonies, such as learning music, learning fine arts, jewelry making, making new friends, anything that requires softness, anything that requires development, anything that requires beauty. Misra Nakshatra, they are good for commencement of religious works and Vedic sacrificial rituals, such as the yajnas. They're also good for preparing medicines, for doing welding work, for gas furnace work, electrolysis, electric work, and taking harsh decisions for general welfare. Ugra Nakshatra are nakshatra which are highly aggressive in nature. They have strong tendencies. So they're used to plot against enemies. They're used to overcome. But being aggressive nakshatras, they're also used, can be used to your benefit for turning, for overcoming fears, for overcoming psychological barriers, and to expand your horizon, to expand your corner. They're also suitable for meditation, for litigation, for arms and ammunition, and for work involving fire, violent acts, or poison. Laghu and Kshipra Nakshatra. These are good for giving and taking. When you need fast results in a small time, we use these nakshatras to gain good results. They're used for taking medicines. They're also used for constructing, traveling, shop opening, finance, acquisition of knowledge, forming partnerships. And all partnerships can be formed here except marriage, which should not take place in the Pushya Nakshatra. So now let's see how different is this from what we so far we've seen that this is done as Muhurta. For choosing Muhurta, we choose a certain nakshatra to do something different, to do something. But let's see, it should have a resonance in the life of the native. These nakshatras or their categories, their qualities should also be imparted in the life of the of a native who has these planets sitting in any particular group of nakshatras. Let's see how these nakshatras play out for individuals. We have Pietro Mennana. He is an Italian sprinter and is known for holding 15 nationals and one European title and a bronze Olympic medal. And he set world record for 200 meters and a world record which is still standing as of 1995. He retired in 1994 and he became a sports consultant to the local government there. They run a sports fair business and he also manages an athletic club. For all that athletic energy that he has, it is very important that there should be some swiftness in his life. The nakshatras should impart some swiftness in his life. He also has a degree in political science and a law and qualified to practice as a public accountant. So the swift nakshatras are also good learners. Let's see how this plays out. We see in his life that Lagna is in Abhijita. The Abhijita nakshatra's longitude starts from 6 degrees 40 minutes to 10 degrees 53 minutes 20 seconds. In sidereal Capricorn, that is from the last quarter of Uttara Ashada to the first 115th part of Shravana. We have for him Mercury in Pushya. Pushya nourishes as well as imparts knowledge, as well as gives him a lot of swiftness in whatever he does. His Lagna is in Abhijita, which is an invincible part, in the invincible part, giving him world records which are still outstanding. And Saturn here for him is in Hasta. Saturn is also the Karaka of legs and it is also his Lagna Lord. Mercury is also his ninth Lord of success, of prosperity, of fame. As we move further, we take the example of Henry Ford. Henry Ford is the American industrialist. He does not require much should I say, introduction here. So we move on to directly his achievements. Henry Ford has, he made the car, which was an expensive commodity, a known name for all Americans, a known commodity for all Americans. We see his Mercury, which is the 11th Lord of gains and the second Lord of wealth in Pushya Nakshatra, in the 12th house of movement. Sun, which is his Lagna Lord, again is in Pushya Nakshatra, which is a Kshipra or a fast moving nakshatra. Taking this forward, we have Ketu, which is his fourth Lord of masses, fourth Lord of home, in his 10th Lord of career. Ketu is in Rohini Nakshatra. Rohini Nakshatra is a Sthira Nakshatra, a nakshatra which is everlasting, which is growing, which has strong growth in terms of it's a very long-term investment kind of a nakshatra. So we see that it grows, his career grew and grew and grew in a long-term basis. A very strong relationship that we can see coming out over here between the nakshatras. Moving ahead, we see how the Ugra nakshatras play up in a person's life. Ted Bundy is known for being a serial killer. He has his Magha nakshatra as his Lagna. This nakshatra gave him aggression, high aggression. Jeshta nakshatra, which is a Tikshna or a very sharp nakshatra, which allows a person to do acts like killing, violence, happens to be in his fourth house of masses and emotion. Because fourth house also represents your family, he has a very strong abusive history from his family. So it, and Mars being his fourth Lord, becomes extremely strong in this nakshatra. This led him to have a very turmoil childhood, and also as such, this gave him a lot of mental, emotional upheaval, which vented out as his being a serial killer and a rapist. Vishakha nakshatra, which is a mixed nakshatra, took color from Mars and a retrograde Mercury sitting in this nakshatra. Mercury is the second Lord of morals and high ground, which he had lost somewhere along the line. Ricardo is another serial killer known for his heinous deeds. So we see 5 out of 9 planets, or 10 planets, including the Lagna, are in the Tikshna and the Ugra category. I need not expand more here because I rest my case. We share this, all this and more, on our online course in nakshatras. This is the way a nakshatra shapes our destiny. But we can always realize that they give us a guiding light. It is up to us whether we want a change or not, because the chart essentially shows you your strength, weaknesses, your opportunities, and your troubles. So be aware, be guided. Thank you.